Celebrates and explores possibly what it means to actually define oneself or a country as America. So this concert today is sort of envisioned as a way of demonstrating the many, many ways music can represent the idea of a country. So the piece we're going to hear right now is one of the most famous American orchestral works. It's by Samuel Barber, called Adagio for Strings. You may know it, it was used very movingly in the film Platoon, and because it's a very somber, sad, tragic piece in certain ways, though I do think it has a lot of hope to it. Also, this piece is sort of a part of American history in that it was performed at the funerals of JFK and FDR. So it's really become a piece of music that has become, well, it was American because it was composed by an American, but became part of American history by being used at these events, these historical events, as well as in a very famous American film about a very controversial topic, the Vietnam War. So this is a beautiful, very tragic piece, but as I said, I think there's a lot of hope in it. And I think in that way, it also sort of points out to this sense of optimism and a sense of hope that America has represented for many people. So even though it's a tragic sounding piece, I hope you agree with me that there's an intensity and there's a hope to it that comes across. This is a piece just for strings, and it highlights this body of the orchestra. It also highlights the wonderful work of my colleagues who are our faculty section leaders, Ethan Wood, Adrian Taylor, John Badawas, and Williams Carrasco. So you'll hear the work that they do with our students week in and week out in this piece in particular. Hope you enjoy it. I swear. A lot of setup, but pretty soon we're going to just be on stage for the rest of the time. We're going to be performing a piece, not a very well-known piece by Aaron Copland, but a beautiful piece. You may know Copland, he's one of America's greatest composers, probably is the most important orchestral composer in American history. He was well known for first adopting jazz and then bringing that into classical music in the 1920s, and then famously bringing in American folk tunes, particularly fiddle tunes and cowboy songs, to his music. You probably know him from Appalachian Spring, his use of the Shaker melody, Simple Gifts, 'Tis a gift to be simple, 'tis a gift to be free, Fanfare of the Common Man. And if you're of a certain age, he wrote a piece that was used in the American beef industry commercials in the 90s. Remember beef, it's what's for dinner? Go back and go on YouTube and remember that. That he used in that commercial, he used Copland's, one of the movements from his ballet, Rovio, the hoedown movement. So trust me, you'll recognize it. We're going to perform one of those movements from the ballet Suite to Rodeo. This movement doesn't actually use any American folk tunes, but in a sense, it actually is sort of more quintessentially American than the rest of the piece, and I'll explain why. A lot of people point to Copland's particular use, or his unique use, of certain kinds of harmonies and intervals called open fifths, and these are kind of combinations of notes that kind of have sort of a beautiful, still, empty quality to them. Hard to describe, but he's a very distinctive sound, and many people really, when they hear Copland, it seems to call to mind or evoke the Great Plains, the prairie, the grandeur of the West. So this piece, this chorale nocturne, a nocturne is a night piece, so it's meant to evoke the evening. I kind of think that this is evoking a bunch of cowboys and cowgirls and cowhands around the chorale at the end of a long day of herding dogies. And they're looking up at the stars, and they're looking at the Great Plains and the prairie. And so the piece evokes this sense of stillness and peacefulness, as well as sort of the emptiness of the American landscape and the prairie right there. So this is, it doesn't use folk tunes, but it evokes this kind of geographical sense that Copland is well known for. So it's a short piece, but it's very, very lovely, the chorale nocturne from his ballet Rodeo.
Thank you.
Oh, you should have, thanks. So America oftentimes is known for its innovation, or all the things we created, baseball, sort of, right? Apple computer, the center, the internet, kind of. Jazz, rock and roll, funk, hip hop, yes. And this piece you're about to hear is follows in that tradition. It's a brand new piece. It's never been performed before. This is the world premiere, and it's really exciting for us as an orchestra to bring a piece to life for the first time ever, but also to share it with you, because this piece is a great piece, and it would be wonderful if it becomes a standard piece of the orchestral repertoire. And that's not crazy to think, because actually, one of the most popular orchestra pieces of the last 30 or 40 years, it's a piece called Short Ride in a Fast Machine by an American composer, believe it or not, named John Adams. And it was premiered in Mansfield at the Greatwood Center in the early 80s, and it has since become one of the most important and most popular pieces of orchestra music in the country, right here. So I'll take it, Mansfield. Well, Norton's gonna represent, isn't it? That's right. And this piece actually borrows from that, not literally, but it's a very, this piece we're about to hear, Vamos, Let's Go, borrows from the excitement of that piece. And so it's a really fun, about 3 or 4 minute orchestral overture. You know, Josh draws upon a lot of influences in his music, composer Josh Rodriguez. I hear a lot of funk and hip hop in this piece, as I'll demonstrate in just a minute. He also draws, in his music, he draws on his Latin American heritage, and also on his knowledge of the Western classical tradition. And sort of in this way, this piece is really an American piece. We have an immigrant composer who studied at the Cleveland Institute of Music at UCLA, studied Western classical music, brought his own lived experience and his love of popular music together into a brand new piece that we're going to bring to you. Only in America, right? So what's cool about this piece is that it's an homage, if you will, to Beethoven. And what he did is he took the idea for this piece, actually, was he took the letters in the name Beethoven, B-E-E-T-H-O-V-N, and he figured out a way to assign each of those letters to a musical note. Then he came up with a rhythm, and that's the main melody of this piece. Now, if I didn't tell you that, you wouldn't know it. But I'm going to show you how that works. So we're going to demonstrate this main rhythm that's based on the word and the name Beethoven. And like in a great funk tune, it's in the basses and the piano. So we're going to try that right now. Just now, I'm not expecting you to hear that, but trust me, this is the name Beethoven put to music. We're just going to show you that. This is not the piece. This is just the... So don't clap. Okay, so this is just kind of... So that is the main melody of this piece. Now this piece has a lot going on, but all the way through there's this funky bass line that's kind of the melody. So this is a piece called Vamos, and so I suppose we should say, let's go. Thank you. may be a classic. It's so fun. It's so fun. All I do is go down, left, right, up. It's so easy for me. I mean, you know, they're the ones doing all the work. So, and we're really excited to have brought that to life for the first time ever. So thanks for sharing that experience with us right here at Eaton College. Go Norton. So the main project for us for the semester has been this extraordinary piece called The Montgomery Variations, and that's what we're about to perform for you. It's a piece about 20 minutes long, a little bit more than that. It's a theme and variation, so that means it's an extended piece of music that's based on a tune, a melody. Composers have been writing themes and variations for a long time, and usually it's on the piece is based on a tune that sort of everybody knows. So what would happen is, like, let's imagine you went to see an opera, you know, in like Vienna, 1780 or something, or maybe 1760. When did Mozart die? Yeah, I think he was still alive. Anyway, and you would hear a tune that you liked. Well, then you'd go home, and instead of turning on the radio, because you didn't have a radio or electricity, you would go to the music store and you would buy a piece that maybe Mozart or someone else wrote based upon that tune. It was like a kind of way of taking the melody that you knew and loved from, you know, the stage, and maybe you could make it your own. You could play it at home, and you could play all different versions of it, you know, fast and slow, etc. It's kind of a way of, again, of taking a piece that you knew and sort of getting to know, almost like a character study. Now, Margaret Bonds, the composer of this piece, did this with a piece of music that her community would have known very well. It's a spiritual called I Want Jesus to Walk With Me. Now, this piece was written during the Civil Rights era. As you may know, spirituals and gospel music were a hugely important part of the Civil Rights Movement. The Black Church led the charge in the Civil Rights Movement. Gospel songs were sung at the March on Washington, and spirituals were a part of organizing for the movement. The famous song from the Civil Rights Movement, We Shall Overcome, was actually based on a gospel song from the early 20th century called I Shall Overcome Someday. So Margaret Bonds knew this piece, and she was inspired by Martin Luther King and the Civil Rights Movement to take this melody and essentially give it the orchestral treatment, bring it to life in this sort of powerful, imposing, and inspiring way. So the entire piece is based upon this tune. Now, many of you may not know this, so for this piece to work, you kind of have to know the tune. So in your program, there is actually the music, if it's light enough for you to see. So with your permission, even if you don't give me your permission, we're going to sing it so we can all learn how it goes. I'll start. So I'll stand up here and sing myself. If you want to join in, that's fine. It's a spiritual. You don't have to be Black to sing it. You don't have to be Christian to sing it. Don't sing it if you don't want to. Think of it as an artifact of American history that has been playing an important role in not just this piece, but in the grand tradition of African-American culture and the Civil Rights Movement. So could somebody make you move? Okay, good. So here's how that's going to work. How am I going to do this with a microphone? Okay, so you got to start. Here's what we're going to start doing. We're going to make it a little bit like gospel. So we're going to do this. Can I do this? We're going to do a stomp and a clap, but don't speed up. So go like this. Don't speed up. You're going to want to speed up. Just keep it nice and relaxed. Ready? So it goes like this. Keep it going, and you just join in. We're going to do it a couple times. You join when you can. Ready? Ready? I want Jesus to walk with me. I want Jesus to walk with me. All along my pilgrim journey, I want Jesus to walk with me. Again, ready? Louder, ready? I want Jesus to walk with me. I want Jesus to walk with me. All along my pilgrim journey, Lord, I want Jesus to walk with me. That's great. That's great. So you're going to hear that melody from the very beginning and then all the way through the piece in various different guises. I mean, Margaret Bonds chose it not just because it's part of her tradition, but because the words themselves, right? Needing some kind of hope and power and faith to carry her and her community members and the country forward. This is an extraordinary piece. It's an amazing story about how it came to light, and that's in your program. But for now, please enjoy this extraordinary work of the Montgomery Variations. Thank you.
Thank you.
it was an extraordinary piece, and really, really powerful. And everyone in the orchestra deserves a solo bow, because every single part is difficult. So, extraordinary piece. Thank you for sharing it with us tonight. It's an amazing piece. I'm really glad to we had a chance to present it to you. What a testament to hope and faith, and the best of what America can be. Now, America brought us a lot of things, including Hollywood and Star Wars. And I don't know about you, but or many of the people behind me, but it was the music of John Williams that really got me into classical music, that showed me what it could be, what it might feel like to write a piece for orchestra, to learn about classical music, and also maybe want to be an astronaut. So next best thing is to program a piece from some of John Williams' oeuvre. This is a medley from The Empire Strikes Back. It's May the 7th instead of May the 4th, but we're a little behind by the tractor beam. So this is our final piece of the program. Thank you again so much for joining us for this concert. If you do play an instrument, if you know someone who plays an instrument who wants to join us on stage, reach out to me at the end of August. We'll be doing auditions for the fall semester. So we'll finish up with The Empire Strikes Back then.